In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. My dear friends, today we will read Paul's first letter to Timothy. It's a pastoral letter. It is a letter to the pastor, not only to community of those who follow Jesus Christ as their Savior, but to the one who loves God very much, and Apostle Paul as a teacher, as the one on whom God had mercy. He is sharing these amazing words and teachings. From Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by order of God, our Savior, and Christ Jesus, our hope. Again, he is mentioning God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. He is our hope. Through him, everyone could get to God the Father. To Timothy, my true son in the faith, may God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord give you grace, mercy, and peace. I want you to stay in Ephesus, just as I urged you when I was on my way to Macedonia. Some people there are teaching false doctrines, and you must order them to stop. As you know, that Apostle Paul was preaching where no one was preaching, Yeshua Mashiach resurrected, Jesus Christ Messiah resurrected. And there was a false teachers from Judaism and from Gnostics. They were preaching completely different Christ Jesus as he was in reality. That's why Apostle Paul, he wants Timothy to go there and to stop those teaching. It's only empty words. There is no grace in them. If there is no grace, there is no forgiveness and salvation of the soul. Tell them to give up those legends and those long lists of ancestors. Again, the family tree, like at that time, particularly Jewish people, they were holding everyone, their family tree. They were boasting, but the circumcision of the heart, it is more important than anything. And you don't need your ancestors believing in Christ, because Christ is acting through the soul who believes to him, which only produce, you know, those lists of ancestors, arguments. They do not serve God's plan, which is known by faith. What is it exactly, God's plan? That Christ on Good Friday died instead of us. We don't have to kill anymore any animal, lamb or whatever, but we have to kill bad habits in our heart. We have to repent. Repenting, it is like killing all that wrong stuff that we used to do before we realize that Jesus is our Savior, and believing in him gives eternal life to our immortal soul. The purpose of this order is to arouse the love that comes from a pure heart, a clear conscience, and a genuine faith. Therefore, there's nothing to say more. Love comes through the pure heart. You know the Psalm 50 or 51? Pure heart, create in me, O God. And create, it is used the word bara. You know, in the Bereshit bara, this is the second word of the beginning of the Torah, of the first letter of Moses. And only God could bara. Means bara in Aramaic language, create something from nothing, give the possibility to live. And pure heart, God is acting through the pure heart. These are the words of Psalm 50, the Psalm of David, after he had sinned and God forgave him. Some people have turned away from these and have lost their way in foolish discussions. They want to be teachers of God's law, but they do not understand their own words or the matters about which they speak with so much confidence. Like if somebody is preaching something, talking, he just found some false, popular, famous, and he doesn't believe, there is no grace in that. He will not convince even anyone, but he could stop the time of the spiritual progress and development. We know that the law is good if it is used as it should be used. It must be remembered, of course, that laws are made not for good people. This is so important for us to understand and not to be sorry that we were not under the law of Moses, because law was given for those, like, the laws are made not for good people, but for lawbreakers and criminals, for the godless and sinful, for those who are not religious or spiritual, for those who kill their fathers or mothers, for murderers, for the immoral, for sexual perverts, for kidnappers, for those who lie and give false testimony, or who do anything else contrary to sound doctrine. Therefore, we see that the law is given, there was necessity because of the sin. And the law showed that the wages of the law is death. That was not a good news. The good news is that Jesus is paying our debts before God the Father. This is the good news. And only with the pure heart we could accept Jesus, to see what is wrong in our life and to be grateful to him that he was and is and will be until his second coming save us. I give thanks to Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength for my work. I thank him for considering me worthy and appointing me to serve him. When this happened, chapter 9, the Acts of the Apostles. And what was happening there? Shaul, rabbi, was going to persecute, probably to kill Christians in Damascus. And the light from heaven appeared to him, and there was a verse. Shaul, Shaul, why do you persecute me? Christ identified himself, resurrected Jesus, Yeshua Mashiach, with those whom Shaul was persecuting. You know that story. Even though in the past I spoke evil of him and persecuted and insulted him, but God was merciful to me because I did not yet have faith and so did not know what I was doing. And he is calling himself in another letter like idiot he was acting. Like the one who is like a stillborn, being rabbi, he is calling himself, his actions. And our Lord poured out his abundant grace on me and gave me the faith and love which are ours in union with Christ Jesus. This is true saying, to be completely accepted and believed. Now he's saying like a very nice words, like a verse, like a poem, little poem. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. I am the worst of them. When do we hear these words? Before we are approaching, when we are coming to communion, the church is using these words. But God was merciful to me in order that Christ Jesus might show his full patience in dealing with me, the worst of sinners, as an example for all those who would later believe in him and receive eternal life. Believing in Jesus means receiving eternal life when we are staying in that special grace, as Apostle Paul did, and this is the great mercy to everyone, and starting from Apostle Paul probably, to the eternal King. Again, he's calling Christ King, and it's not only culture to become a Christian, because many people, they like the costumes, they like the culture, they like special events that used to be before even Christianity. but he is calling Christ King, and it means that we belong to that kingdom. We are King's children, sons and daughters, to the eternal King, immortal. This King is immortal. Every king had died before, but this King is immortal, invisible to those who are not using the eyes of the faith. The only God, to him be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. These are amazing words. Timothy, my child, I entrust to you this command, which is in accordance with the words of prophecy spoken in the past about you. What it means? It means there are some prophecies, somebody pronounced prophecies about Timothy. His mother was Jewish, he was not circumcised, but Paul did it once when he was entering in Jerusalem and like preaching to among Jewish people, and his father was Greek, and also he was like welcome to Greek community, to pagans of that time, but he probably spoke two languages, even more than that, maybe Roman also. Use those words as weapons in order to fight well and keep your faith in a clear conscience. Some people have not listened to their conscience and have made a ruin of their faith. Therefore, conscience is very important, but conscience of Christ, when there is a mind of Christ, that conscience is important. At that point, we will not ruin our faith if we will follow Jesus always. Among them are Hymenaeus and Alexander. He's mentioning two names who abandoned Christ probably and ruined their faith, whom I have punished by handing them over to be power of Satan. It's something terrible happened. And they choose that wrong way, serving not God, but opposite, Antichrist probably. We are not realizing that when we are not doing God's job, when we are not acting according to Christ's good news teaching, we are acting according to Antichrist. And he, like, punished by them, by handling them over to be power of Satan. This will teach them to stop their blasphemy against God, preaching or behaving. Apostle Paul did this in order to cut that wrong teaching in a new community, but he is saying in different letters, love those people anyways, try to get them back in right faith, and through repentance they will become again God's children. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ.